Hello everybody, it's Lenka here and welcome to my live stream session. Thanks for joining us. We're going to play some songs for you. I'd like to introduce my friend and guitar player, Trey Lockerbie. Hi, Trey.
Hello, Internet.
Internet. Thanks for joining us wherever you are. We're going to play some tunes and we're going to have a chat and we're going to start with this song, Nothing Here But Love. Lying under saddened sun, the day is done, my heart is one. We hold each other, friends or lovers, high above. There's nothing here but you and me. We'll never end. We're innocent, we're heaven sent. We're born together, die together, live forever. There's nothing here but love, sweet love. It's all we know, so can I show you love, sweet love. Take time to grow, there's nothing here but love. Take me where the days are fun, where everyone knows everyone. We'll love together, live together. We will never be let down. Oh, you will see, it's meant to be. We're living life, we're wild and free. We're falling under wealth and wonder. Oh my darling, there's nothing. Goes wild. Woo! I hope. Thank you. I'm going to answer some questions now. Tara says, what makes Shadows most different from your past albums? Well, it is a lot more quiet and relaxing and mellow than my previous two albums. It's almost a return to what I was doing before. I was in a band called Decoder Ring and we made quite dreamy, ambient kind of stuff. So I'd always wanted to make a sort of a lullaby album, and this is my lullaby album. So it is supposed to make you feel very relaxed and soothed, and hopefully you fall asleep and the songs go into your dreams and then I'm inside your subconscious. That's my plan.
Inception.
Inception, yeah. Look out. We're going to be operating on another plane. Ben says, what is your favorite US city for its food? When I first read it, I thought it was just international, and I was going to say Singapore for the chili crab, but US. It's a toss-up, depending on my mood. If I'm feeling healthy, then LA, because there's all these awesome hippie restaurants like Cafe Gratitude, where you can get really yummy, am I right?
Yep.
Really yummy, healthy food, and they've all got
you
names.
You are
like,
right.
Like, I am humble. Right. And then when they bring you the food, which is probably brown rice and veggies or something, they say, you are humble, and they give it to you, which is pretty cool. Or if I'm in a completely different mood, like maybe Austin, Texas, and get some like chicken fried steak and some, you know, collard greens and stuff like that, which is really yummy as well. Do you think we should play another song, or should I keep answering? I'll do one more. If you had to pick one, which of your songs is your super special favorite one? Garian has asked this question. Dude, that's so hard for me to answer because they're all my babies and I really just love all my songs. I go through different phases, I think. One song that keeps coming back is the song Skip Along, and I hadn't been playing it for a while, but I recently named my record company after it that I just started, so I've added it back into the set list, and it's from the first album, but I just really, really love it, and it reminds me of a good message, I think, to keep with me. Okay, I'll do a couple more questions. Tom has asked, what current artists have you been listening to lately? Any recommendations? I've been quite enjoying Ellie Goulding. I don't know if you guys know her stuff. She does sort of like slightly left of center, dreamy pop dance stuff. She's from London. I heard one of her songs yesterday whilst bra shopping in Victoria's Secret. And I was reminded at what a talented lass she is and how I do quite like her. I also really like Robin for a similar kind of genre. Yeah, they'd probably be my recommendations. Totally different from my album. It's more like if you're going to be going out that night or if you're cleaning the house, is really good to listen to dance music, particularly Robin. I like to listen to Robin if I'm doing housework. Okay, should we play a song?
Trouble.
Trouble is a friend. I always say. I'll start that one again. Trouble he will find you no matter where you go. Oh, oh. No matter if you're fast, no matter if you're slow. Ow, ow. Storm or the cry in the morning. You're fine for a while, but you start to lose control. He's there in the dark, he's there in my heart. He waits in the wings, he's gotta play a part. Trouble is a friend, yeah, trouble is a friend of mine. Trouble is a friend, but trouble is a foe, ow, ow. And no matter what I feed him, he always seems to grow, oh, oh. He sees what I see and he knows what I know. So don't forget as you ease on down. Trouble is a friend, yeah, trouble is a friend of mine. Ow, ow, so don't be alarmed if he takes you by the arm. I won't let him win, but I'm a sucker for his charm. Trouble is a friend, yeah, trouble is a friend of mine. trouble is a friend. Yeah, trouble is a friend of mine. Ow, ow, so oh, don't be alarmed if he takes you by the arm. I won't let him win, but I'm a sucker for his charm. Trouble is a friend. Yeah, trouble is a friend of mine. Oh. Trouble is a friend. Before we go any further, I have to say a very special birthday message to a very special friend called Misha. Happy birthday, darling. I love you. She's turning 7 and she lives in LA. Okie dokie. This is good, these kind of gigs for little kids to be able to watch, because it's very rare to play shows where 7-year-olds can attend. So I love it. Okay. Kiara has asked, what do you like to do to relax and unwind? Well, I love going to the movies, but I never hardly ever get to go. I love nature, so I spend as much time as possible under a tree, looking up, ideally lying down and looking up at the tree. I like to make craft and find that, I guess, it's not that relaxing, but I like it. And I like reading, you know, regular stuff. David asks, what kind of music did you grow up listening to and who is your all-time favourite? Well, my dad's a jazz musician. He plays trad, kind of 1940s jazz. So I grew up listening to Ella Fitzgerald and Billie Holiday and stuff like that, as well as the Beatles, and 60s kind of pop, I guess. And then I was a child of the 80s, 90s era, so I was pretty into like Madonna and Kylie Minogue and the Bangles. And then in the 90s I was into like Tori Amos, Fiona Apple. And as you can see, I guess the influences are starting to come in, although I wasn't really playing music at that point. Then I discovered Bjork, and that kind of blew my mind, and I was probably a late teen at that point, and I became a huge fan of hers, and she would be my number one all-time favourite inspiration. And I guess she sort of just taught me that anything was really possible with music, and I didn't. It sort of unlocked something inside me to help me go on a journey to find my own voice and start doing my own music. Play another song. Is that now?
That was earlier.
That was earlier. I'm reading from a computer. Okay, Jilly T. Why are Aussies so funny and kind? Oh, thank you. I've never met someone from Australia I haven't liked. Well, that's great. There's something in the water down there, I don't know. But I agree. And we do travel a lot, so I'm sure a lot of you can agree that there are Aussies everywhere, all over the world. And yeah, we're a pretty good sort. I don't know why. We're very down-to-earth people, I guess. Yeah, maybe that's why. Audrey, or Audrey, depending on how you pronounce it. How do you feel you have changed as an artist and a person since your last record? Well, something huge happened to me, and that is I became a parent. So that I found a tremendous change in my life, and, you know, both practically, logistically, as well as psychologically, emotionally, spiritually, physically, hormonally, everything changed. You know what? I was pregnant last time I did live stream in 2011. I was preggers. There's a photo on the wall of me over there, and I wasn't really showing. I just looked like I had a big lunch because I think I was only about 4 or 5 months pregnant. But now he's out in the world and he's challenging and inspiring, and he has definitely affected the way that I make music. There's quite a few songs about him on the new record, and also I guess I spend a lot of time just hanging out with him at the park, so I have to be really careful about how I schedule my life with music so that, you know, he can come first, I guess. Yeah. Okay, one more question, I guess, and then we'll play another song. Heike Wiefel, I'm assuming Deutsch? Yes, because the question says, will you record any tracks with Nick Howard, or did you just do some songwriting together? Greetings from Germany. Hello, guten Tag, wie geht's? Gut. I did write a song with Nick Howard, who, for those of you who don't know who he is, he won The Voice in Germany. And he's an English dude, actually. We wrote a song together, and it's pretty cool, actually. We wrote a couple of duets, and we'll see. It's not recorded yet, so if it turns out good, then hopefully you'll hear it. I really like it, and yeah, you'll see. We'll see. We'll just have to see. Kevin Kennedy, do you have favourite genres in reading or do you mix it up a lot? I am sorry to say, or I don't know if I should apologise, depends on your taste. I really like YA adventure fiction, which is like young adult written for 17-year-olds, because, you know, when we're on the road, I don't want to be challenged. I just want to read something kind of a little bit junky, so books like Divergent, Ready Player One was really good. I'm always looking for more, so if you have any suggestions of good YA books, not like schmaltzy, not too much about vampires and like which boy am I going to choose, but more like apocalyptic adventure stories, send them my way, because yeah, I'd be happy to get them on the Kindle and read them in the van. I also really love Murakami, Tom Robbins, David Sedaris. That's all I can think of. Let's play another song. This song's called Heart to the Party. Heart to the Party, if you live in Boston.
Once I woke up, I could see the dream was real. Once I woke up, I could see the dream was real. The key fit the lock, and then all that I could feel was the moon shining bright on the midnight trees. And I'm sailing along on the deep blue seas. So and
Okay. So, Laura, I'm going to answer your question, which is, what has been the best gift you've ever received from a fan? I don't know about the best, but I want to tell you about something that I received recently in Korea from a fan at the festival that we went to recently. And this lovely fan gave me a present when I was signing autographs. And she was like, I didn't know what to get you, so I thought I'd get you something that you could use. And she got me a bag of stationery of like everything you could think of, including plastic sleeves, white out, we call it, or you guys like that white stuff to, you know, cover up your mistake, all different colored pens, pencils, highlighters, erasers, pretty much anything that you can think of in the stationery department, she gave me. It was amazing. I was like, that, how did you even think of doing that? It was so weird, but it was great. Yeah, I'd say that might be the best. Okay. Alison, what is your earliest music-related memory? Something that comes to mind is hearing the song I'm Walking on Sunshine on the radio. I was probably like 4 or something when that came out and just really, really liking it. That was probably my first favourite song, I think. I'm walking on sunshine, whoa! Kind of gives you an idea about what kind of little girl I was. Mostovoi Molokai. I don't know if I pronounced that correctly, but you have a great name. Are you planning to include South America in your tours? Dude, I wish I could. I have some fans there, but I don't think I have enough to sort of get an invitation to go play there. I'm waiting. I'll pick up the phone if somebody my people will pick up the phone. If somebody would love to have me go play a festival, I would love to, but so far it hasn't happened and I would really, really like to because it's one continent that I haven't really travelled. I've only been to Mexico, so I have some countries to check out there and I would love to play for you guys. Emma, what advice do you have for young artists looking to make a career out of music? Get out while you can. Just kidding. That's so
stay
mean.
Stay in school.
Stay in school. Find a fallback. I'm being a mum now. My advice would be write your own songs. Try and get good at it and try and find something unique that nobody else is doing and do it really well. And then find a way to share it with the world. I would say hit up the blogs because that seems to be the way that we all communicate creatively at the moment. It's definitely a challenging industry and it's changing all the time. Since I got started as a singer-songwriter, it's changed and it still is changing as we all kind of tread through this new world of internet-related business and I don't know, it's interesting. I would also say that, you know, only do it if you really, really love it. Otherwise, keep it as a hobby. It's one of those things that's sort of like if you love cooking, you don't become a cook. I've got a girlfriend who's like the best cook and we're always saying, you have to open a cafe. And she's like, no, because I don't want to stop enjoying cooking. Because when it becomes your job, it's your job. You know, I love what I do, but it's like I'm like on the clock working rather than just like, you know, doing it for fun. So I think that's a choice that one has to make if they're a young musician. Is this what I want to do as my career all the time, live and breathe? I'll do one more question and then we'll play another tune. Lily King, hello from DC. Hello, we're going to be in your town soon, in a few days. We'll be in Arlington, which I hear is right near DC, so hopefully you're coming to the show. Who or what inspires your sense of style? You really inspire my style. Cool. Thanks, Lily. I guess I like a kind of a vintage-y thing. I like silhouettes from eras gone by, but I kind of mix it up a bit. I like feminine clothes and fun clothes. I like things that reference nature, like this floral dress, which is vintage. I always have to cut everything off because I'm so short. So look. This dress was like this long. And it looked really bad on me. So I cut it off and now it looks okay. I also get inspired by things like sort of fairy tale characters or sort of feminine icons, I guess. And I like to reference things and mishmash stuff together. It's fun. I love clothes. I'm not a huge fashion junkie, but I love clothes. All right. Speaking of nature, we're going to play a song from my new album called After the Winter. And this is kind of a little fable or a nursery rhyme sort of song for a kid, I guess. All about the seasons and emotions.
When the rain is falling down and there's snowflakes on your cheek, when your heart is frozen over and hasn't seen the sun in, just remember, after the winter comes the spring, that's when the bluebirds start to sing, and you can always count on this. Going under, and your eyes are full of tears. When the bears are all in hiding, and you are hiding too. Oh, darling, just remember that everything will soon be new, because after the winter comes the spring.
Questions, shall we? Thanks for tuning in, you guys. I hope that you're enjoying the experience. Corey, I'm going to answer your question. If you could only bring three belongings with you on tour, what would they be and why? Mm. Well, I've kind of got to say clothes, don't I? Because otherwise I'd be naked. It's pretty hard. Okay, assuming that I am allowed to have my clothes and it's just really about like personal belongings, I'm afraid to say I would bring my iPhone, my laptop and my Kindle because I want to communicate with my family and I want to read my YA books. Amanda, what is the most beautiful place you have ever visited? I think it's probably the hinterlands of Byron Bay. There's some beautiful rainforests. It's in Australia, by the way. It's in the top of New South Wales. It's the easternmost point of Australia. It's a hippie town. And 20 minutes from the coast is just so beautiful. Probably in specific, I would say Wyan State Forest. There's this waterfall that's like a 50 meter drop. It's a really high waterfall. And up the top, there's rock pools. And it's changed now. They've got a fence. But when I went years and years ago, you could go and swim in this rock pool, which only fit about 10 people in, and was really deep and warm. And you're really close to the edge of this massive drop. You're only a few meters away. And you could duck dive down into the rock pool. And then you walk. It takes about an hour to walk down to the bottom. And at the bottom, it's like cold and the waterfall's falling on you and you swim down there. And what's very interesting about this place is that it was an Aboriginal sacred area for males where they would do like secret men's business. And modern scientists have discovered that there is a mineral in the rocks that affects testosterone. So there you go. Next question, Jason E. Koulian. Lenka, my neighbour wonders where you get some of your dresses from. We've both noticed how neat they are. Well, I like vintage shopping at markets and vintage stores. I don't know where you live, but one of the places that I really like to go is called Shireen Vintage in downtown LA, and there's one in New York as well, and she has a huge collection of old dresses and a lot of the kinds of dresses that I like to wear, and they're quite cheap and they're really special. I shop at regular places as well, like, you know, particularly when I'm on tour, I just pop into shops and buy things. I'm quite thrifty though. I don't spend a bucket load of money, which is one of the reasons I like vintage clothes, but I love flea markets. It's one of my ideal pastimes is shopping at flea markets. Gosh, there's a lot of talking for me, isn't it? I feel like a newsreader. Next. Karina Huzar. Have you ever had a bad breakup? If so, how did you recover? Oh, what a question. Same way probably most girls do, a lot of crying, hopefully some girlfriends to help you through it.
Some ice cream.
Ice cream, yeah, ice cream for sure. Lying in bed eating ice cream. And luckily for me, I'm a songwriter, so I've got something to channel those kinds of feelings into, and I can write a kind of a mean breakup song and get some of those feelings out. And I find that very cathartic, very healing. It's pretty much my therapy. I haven't had one in a long time though. I've been in a very happy relationship for 7 or 8 years, so I can't hardly even remember what it feels like. If you're going through that, I'm very, very sorry for you. It sucks, but it will pass. The feelings will pass, and you can use my music to help you feel better. You should listen to Wrote Me Out, which was a B-side on the first album, and you should listen to Bring Me Down. That's a really good, like, I won't let this burden bring me down. You can just and walk away. Trey, do you mind doing a tap dance to just give me a little bit of time?
Sure.
Did you bring your tap shoes?
I did bring my tap shoes.
Emily, what inspired the album art and how did that come together? Well, the album art for Shadows is supposed to be like it's my my shadow going behind me, but in the shadow is this whole landscape that has grown up, because in this album, the reason it's called Shadows is shadows represents like all my sort of my memories and my experiences. It's like each song is a shadow, because I sort of see shadows as a metaphor for the past, because they're sort of behind you, or they're like an imprint of you and your life. Yeah, so that's what it is. And my husband / art director, James Gulliver Hancock, made the set pieces, and we set them up in the studio and shot it. We shot it in Sydney with friends helping us. And I styled it myself. I'm wearing a vintage jumpsuit that I got from Zoo Emporium in Sydney. And I'm wearing jewellery by Elke Kramer, who is an amazing jewellery designer who I went to art college with. She's from Sydney, but she's doing really well all over the world. I'll do one more question and then we're going to play another song. Cesar Cotta, or Cesar. Was it difficult taping the dance in your Heart Skips a Beat video all in one take? That's the video where there's the medical thing. I start off in the like medical box operation kind of thing and then dance around. Well, I have to let you in on a little secret. There is one edit in that video, and that is where the lid, like where the box, no, where I get lifted out of the box and it all changes around. We had to do a cut there. So I got to really just do that bit and then do the dancing bit. I think also like I was sort of attached in there or something. We couldn't really continue. But it, for me, it was quite difficult because I'm not the kind of artist that does all that kind of dancing stuff a lot. I thought it would be easy for me because I used to be a dancer and I loved it. And I was like, you know, Britney Spears or whatever, they do that all the time. I'll be fine. But it's actually harder than it looks to learn a dance. So you've got to learn it quite quickly and then to do it really well in front of cameras. It was hard. It was fun. I really liked it. But I definitely have a bit more respect for all those pop stars that do lots of dancing. I learned that it is harder than it looks. Okay, we're going to play a song now that has been on a big commercial all around the world, except for America, but some of you may know this from the Windows 8 commercial and maybe how you discovered me, because I'm seeing that quite a few people are becoming new fans because of this, which is all good. It's called Everything at Once.
Slay as a fox, as strong as an ox, as fast as a hare, as brave as a bear, as free as a bird, as neat as a word, as quiet as a mouse, as big as a house. All I wanna be, sharp as a tooth, as deep as a bite, as dark as the night, as sweet as a song, as right as a wrong, as long as a road, as ugly as a toad, as pretty as a picture hanging from a fixture, strong like a family, strong as I wanna be, bright as day, as light as play, as hard as nails, as grand as a whale. Thank you. sweet as sugar and everything nice. As old as time, as straight as a line, as royal as a queen, as buzzed as a bee, as stealth as a tiger, smooth as a glider, pure as a melody, pure as I wanna be. Oh, like you wanna be.
Thank you kindly. So we just answer a couple more questions and then we'll play another song and then we'll be done. And I thank you very much for listening. Benji, what are you looking forward to most in the next few months? Well, I'm on tour, so I've got a lot of exciting shows coming up. At the moment, starting tomorrow, I'm doing East Coast run of the States and heading up to Canada to play Toronto. So if you're around this area, please come out and see the show. And that's been really fun. We're playing with live strings. It's really a lovely, lovely show. And then I'm heading to Europe and I'm going to be going to some places that I've never been before, like Russia and Turkey. So that'll be awesome. And I guess other than that, well, actually, you know what? I think I'm going to release a remix EP. Do something. I've been getting some remixes and they're pretty cool and I'm really enjoying that. So that's going to come out and it's, you know, it's a very different sound to what you've heard on Shadows. It's the same songs but with beats and it's been pretty cool. So doing that, making another video. Other than that, I'm just hanging out with my little baby and trying to enjoy him as much as possible. Wrap up, say goodbye, plug album, play last song. Letting you in on a secret. He's been chatting to me as well and telling me what to do. Not, you know, like take a breath, say a word, play the keyboard, but, you know. So, yes, it is time to wrap it up. Thank you guys so much for listening. I hope to see you at some of the shows if I'm coming to your town. If not, I really hope you enjoyed this live stream performance. I always love coming in here, so it's really a special experience. And you can buy my album at all the regular places, Shadows. I hope you're enjoying it. We're going to play an oldie bit of goodie for you now. And if you feel like it, you can sing along. No one can see you because you're in the privacy of your own home. So sing it really loud. I'm just a little bit caught in the middle. Life is a maze and love is a riddle. I don't know where to go, can't do it alone. I've tried and I don't know why. Slow it down, make it stop, or else my heart is going to pop. 'Cause it's too much, yeah, it's a lot to be something I'm not. I'm a fool out of love, 'cause I just can't get enough. I'm just a little bit caught in the middle. Life is a maze and love is a riddle. I don't know where to go, can't do it alone. I've tried and I don't know why. But I don't show it, I can't figure it out. It's bringing me down, I know I've got to let it go and just enjoy the show. The sun is hot in the sky, just like a giant spotlight. The people follow the signs and synchronize it. It's a joke, nobody knows. They got a ticket to that show. Yeah, I'm just a little bit caught in the middle. Life is a maze, love is
show it, I can't figure it out. It's bringing me down, I know I've got to let it go and just enjoy the show. I just enjoy the show. Everybody, thanks Trey, goodbye, let's sing along.
I want my money back, I want my money back, I want my money back,
just enjoy the show.
I want my money back, I want my money back,
I want my money back, just enjoy the show.